Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Prajwalit Shikha and today I'm here to talk about SIM number. We all know that a mobile phone cannot work without a tiny chip which is called as SIM card. Now, a SIM card can hold a lot of information and those information I have listed out here. First is ICCID number, then IMSI number, then security authentication information, then ciphering information, temporary information related to your local network, then a list of services a user has access to in a particular network, and then it also contains two passwords. One is personal identification number and second is your personal unblocking code. Now here we are concerned with SIM number. So the first number that a SIM card contains is ICCID number. This number is your SIM number. So what is the full form of ICCID? ICCID stands for Integrated Circuit Card Identifier. And this is your SIM number, where SIM stands for Subscriber Identity Module. This number actually identifies each SIM card internationally. Now what is the format of ICCID or SIM number? So a SIM number comprises of up to 20 digits, where first two digits are fixed, which is for major industry identifier. Then next 2 to 3 digits is country code by International Telecommunications Union. Then 1 to 4 digits is issuer identifier, which uniquely identifies a mobile network operator. Then next 10 digits, which are unique with respect to a mobile SIM card, which is individual account identification or mobile subscription identification number, and this identifies a mobile phone. Now there is one more digit, which is the last digit, which is called as checksum digit, and that digit is decided based on Lund's algorithm. Now let me explain through an example. So there is a number written, which is obviously not ICCID number, just to explain how Lund's algorithm works in deciding this checksum digit. So there is a number 7992739871 and X, where X stands for the checksum digit, which will be decided after performing an operation based on Lund's algorithm on the remaining digits. Now here the steps to be followed are, first step is that we have to double each second digit starting from this checksum digit from the right hand side. So each second digit starting from the rightmost is 1, then 8, then 3, then 2 and 9. So we have to double these digits. So after doubling, in the next row we will have the numbers 7, then double of 9, 18, then 9, double of 2, 4, 7, double of 3, 6, 9, double of 8, 16, 7, double of 1, 2. Now then we have to add each of the digits. So if we have 18, then it will be added as 1 plus 8. 16 will be added as 1 plus 6. So in the next row we are adding the digits and the result would be 67. So now the next step is to multiply 67 by 9 and it will give 603. Now 603 modulus 10. It means that after dividing 603 by 10, we have to see the remainder, which is 3 in this case. So 3 would become your Lund digit. So this way the checksum digit is decided based on Lund's algorithm, and this validates the whole number. Now at the end of the number, you would find written either U or H. Now what are these for? So if U is written, it means that it is your SIM is universal and it can work on all kinds of networks, whether it is 2G, 3G, 4G, etc. But if H is written, it means that it will work only in a specific network. So this is all about your SIM number or ICCID number. Now we will discuss a little bit about IMSI number as well. So what is IMSI? IMSI stands for International Mobile Subscription Identity. It is a unique identifier for a subscriber in the wireless world. So all signaling and messaging in GSM uses IMSI number as primary identifier of a subscriber. So let us look at the format of IMSI number. So IMSI number is 15 digits long number, and its format is MCC, then MNC and MSIN. Now MCC stands for mobile country code, which takes up first 3 digits. Then we have mobile network code, which is the next 2 digits. And then the rest of the 10 digits is mobile subscriber identification number. Now as for example, first 3 digit, which is mobile country code, it can be 404, which is for India. Then next is mobile network code, which is of 2 digit. It can be 01, which is for Vodafone. And then we have next 10 mobile subscriber identification number, which is basically a sequential serial number. Now neither of these two is your mobile phone number. So mobile phone number is basically called as MSISDN number, and it stands for Mobile Station International Subscriber Directory Number. Now this number is basically used to call to another mobile device and set up a connection between those two. Now let us quickly look at the structure of a SIM card. Now I must tell you that in the very beginning, what was the size of a SIM card? So it used to look like this debit card. So the size of a debit or credit card was the size of the SIM card, which was used in the very beginning. Now after that, the sizes kept on reducing, and nowadays what we use is the SIM card of almost this size. So this is the size that we use nowadays. So SIM cards now comes in 3 different sizes, and we call them according to their size. We call them as standard SIM, micro SIM or nano SIM. Now standard SIM is of size 25x15 mm, and then a micro SIM size is 15x12 mm, and a nano SIM size is 12.3x8.8 mm. Now we have, in addition to these portable SIMs, we have an embedded SIM as well, which is already inserted inside a mobile phone, which cannot be taken out or is not portable. So that is called as embedded SIM, and the size of embedded SIM is about 6x5 mm. Now inside the SIM card, as you can see, the SIM card has various sections in it, so it performs various functions. So I have just drawn roughly the diagram. Here each of the segments represents something. So here one is for VCC, which is for power supply. Now a SIM card can work on various power supply. In the very beginning, when the size was about the size of a debit or credit card, the power supply used to be 5 volt for working of a SIM card. But nowadays it ranges from 3 volt to 1.8 volts. Now 2 is for reset, 3 is for clock, 4 is for optional USB, and 5 is ground, 6 is voltage programmable power, and 7 is your input output data pin. So this is all about the SIM card. Now there are some other features also of SIM card, like since I told you that it can store some data, so it has a CPU, it has RAM, it has ROM, it has EEPROM, etc., which you can explore on your own. So I hope this information is useful. Whenever a mobile phone starts, then what happens? So now I'm going to talk about the authentication process. When a mobile phone starts, it obtains IMSI number from the SIM card. Then that information is passed on to the mobile operator, requesting access and authentication. For that, a personal identification number is passed. Then what happens? The SIM card reveals the information, and then the operator searches for IMSI and associated key, which is the authentication key, which is very important in starting your mobile phone. So then what happens? If that IMSI and associated key is found, then it signs in with KI and it generates a random number, say for example KC1. What happens? Then the operator sends the same number to the mobile device, and then that number is passed on to SIM card. Then the card signs in with the authentication key and generates another random number, which is KC2. Now if KC1 matches with KC2, after comparison, if a match is being found, then the access is granted. Now next we'll talk about how to find out SIM number on your phone. So to find a SIM number, you may go to settings, go to about phone, about device, and then in status, you would find out IMEI number, ICC ID number, etc. Then you may also try out typing this *111*2# and then you will be able to see your SIM number and various other informations you may also be able to explore using this. Now let us quickly talk about SIM card structure. It is basically made up of PVC and semiconductors, and SIM cards are used in mobile phones. Other than that, they are also used in satellite phones, smartwatches, computers and cameras. SIM circuit actually is part of a big universal circuit, which is called as the universal integrated circuit card. Hope the topics discussed in this present video is useful for you. Thank you so much for watching.